I'm Matthew Schellhorn. I'm a concert pianist and an educator. I live in London. Find music too stimulating to relax to, because I just can't switch off from it. I can't stop identifying what the key is or what the instruments are, what the form of the piece is. So I can't really listen to music to relax. Teacher at school was playing in assemblies, and she noticed that I was gawping at the instrument and the way she was using it. And so she called my mother in and suggested that I might like to have piano lessons. And my mother said, you know, do you think you might be musical? And she said, yes, very much so. So that's how it began. It was other people really spotting the way I was responding to music myself. It's good just to draw out what's natural. I'm quite relaxed about who I'm open to. If I say I am an admirer of any one particular musician, it will start to obsess me, perhaps. And so I'd like to just remain open and be ready to hear new things in performances which I haven't previously found exciting. The best thing about being a performer is being in the middle of the creation, having a way to communicate that's not verbal, and in a way that you can craft in your hands. Early memories for me, such as playing the piano in my bedroom, when my piano was in my bedroom for my grandfather, that's something which I sometimes think about when I'm playing live. Memories of concerts that went well, funny moments. I remember there was a time I was playing a Mozart concerto in St. John Smith Square, and I was just on the brink of a cadenza, just the focal point of the phrase, and it was in the early days of mobile phones. This horrible Nokia ringtone going off just at the middle of the moment. But you know, it kind of teaches you not to take yourself too seriously. It's just so much a part of what you do. I wish I knew why music was so important, actually, because then I'd be able to not only answer the question, but be able to understand part of my life. One of the things I've been doing more recently is writing. It's a way of communicating, and it's a way of crafting something and committing your feelings for an audience to be able to relate with. So writing, perhaps. Music's also quite poetic, I think, so poetry. And then sometimes I think, you know, maybe a chess player or something like that, because there's something very tactical in putting together a concert and a performance of pieces, or recording. It's a bit like a puzzle. So there's a kind of gaming, something wacky, probably, if I weren't a musician. Has been difficult. Practice has been really difficult, actually, partly because the house is always full, and generally speaking, I just can't practice with people in the house, or I prefer to practice when everyone's asleep. It's not something which I would like to last much longer either. I think it's been telling, actually, the way people have needed to communicate face to face and set up alternative ways, and the musicians particularly have been at the forefront, I think, of that, putting on concerts. And, you know, one of the first things I noticed was musicians straight away producing videos and content and adapting relatively quickly, and lots of people have been saying, you know, hopefully after this people will remember how important music was to everyone and how important it is. I think hone your skills, and if you're a composer, churn out notes, and if you're a performer, you know, it's really crucial to do the nitty gritty, I think. So yes, I think practice and enjoy the practice. It's a necessity.